arts and climate symposium.
Say one more time.
Arts and climate symposium.
Yeah. So I'll just put this, I will. And you'll just read this. Do you have a script? Did I send you a script?
I don't believe.
I don't think so. So let me do that as well. Sorry, folks. We're over time. I will. I'm organizing, right?
Yeah.
The Arts and Climate Symposium. And just say, you know, a little short sentence, but if everybody wants to embellish my little introduction, you may, please, but keep it short because we want to we're trying to keep this to 20 minutes.
Yeah.
And so let me share this and I'll send it to you, Aaron.
Sure.
And I want to send this to everyone. Do we say where we are and who we are? I didn't write that in this time, Victoria. But we can. I'll tell you what. When I, why don't we just, if you just say, I'll introduce in the very beginning, each of you. I'll just name your first name and you just say who you are and where you are. And that's all. Okay. And we'll just, that's how we'll start. So let me get my script ready. Okay. So we're starting here. Tony is going to start us out. And everybody
that
ready?
That will be Eric.
Yes. Eric is our Tony tonight. And so, okay, Angel.
Are we ready to begin?
Yes.
Okay. Well, places everyone, time for our rehearsal. We're getting ready for the big show in March and April, Climate Collaboratory, the musical. Today, we're reading the script for Partnerships for the Global Goals. They're part of our blueprint for the World House. Ready? And action.
Hello and welcome to Building Community in a Changing Climate, a collaborative storytelling adventure with the Interfaith Climate Group. We invite people of all ages in Alachua County, Florida, and our global networks of support to help tell the story of one human family and one Earth community with a common destiny. So let's introduce all of our cast for this evening. We'll start with Victoria. Oh, you're muted.
Hello, I'm Victoria Alvarez, and I live in Weston.
Okay, and so Marie.
Hi, I'm Sol Marie Duncan, and I live in Gainesville, Florida.
And Helen.
I am Helen Warren, and I also live in Gainesville, Florida.
And Eric.
Hello, I'm Eric Essling, and I also live in Gainesville, Florida.
And Aaron.
Hi, I'm Aaron Culverson, and I'm on that train in Gainesville, Florida.
Right, so there you have our Florida network, and then we have some in our global network of support. Tabby?
Hi, I'm Tabby Gilbert, and I am in Annville, Pennsylvania.
And Shannon?
Hi, I'm Shannon Crossbear, and I'm coming from northern Minnesota on the shores of Lake Superior, the homelands of the Ojibwe people.
Okay, and you can take it away, Shannon.
Well, welcome everybody to the Story Circle. This is where we have the sages of the ages that are gathered around a fire. I have a fire in back here. But we're going to share the words of wisdom from the human family. And for thousands of years, prophets and seers have told of a time of peace on our planet. So we want you to listen to these words of wisdom that are part of our human story.
From the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., this is the great new problem of mankind. We have inherited a big house, a great world house in which we have to live together. Black and white, Easterners and Westerners, Gentiles and Jews, Catholics and Protestants, Muslim and Hindu, a family unduly separated in ideas, culture, and interests, who, because we can never again live without each other, must learn somehow in this one big world to live with each other.
And from the Jewish teachings, behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity.
From Bishop Bill Swing, this could be the time for people of all faiths to move beyond ancient hostilities and suspicions and to discover the untapped potential of cooperation.
And from Bishop Desmond Tutu, my humanity is bound up in yours, for we can only be human together.
From Hadir Al-Mosawi, dialogue demands more courage than waging war. It takes you to that uncomfortable space where you have to question your own assumptions, and rather than speak on other people's behalf, truly listen to what they have to say. Take it into consideration and present your own views in a way that addresses the misunderstandings that may have arisen.
Ellen? I bet Shannon can read that.
I've got it. From the Native American teachings, treat the earth and all that dwell thereon with respect. Remain close to the Great Spirit. Show great respect for your fellow beings. Work together for the benefit of all mankind.
From the Baha'i teachings, the diversity in the human family should be the cause of love and harmony, as it is in music, where many different notes blend together in the making of a perfect chord.
Ah, there's a song for that. It says, we're all like notes that make up a song. We need everybody, so come on, sing along. Well, we'll just add that, Sue, to our musical menu. And we'll take these words of wisdom with us as we travel on the road to 2030, 2050, and beyond.
All right, let's put all that into a game where kids ask the grown-ups to help build a world that works for all of us. Hey kids, what time is it?
It's time to play the World House Treasure Hunt.
It's time to find the people, places, and things that will help us to make a world that works for all.
In 2015, the United Nations named 17 Sustainable Development Goals.
Go ahead.
We need to win these goals by 2030 so we can make a world that works for all.
Curious minds want to know, the people who are already helping to make the world that works for all life on Earth, including 100% of humanity.
Our roving reporters will talk to real people who are living the global goals.
We'll start right here in Alachua County, Florida. Alachua County folks wave.
And if they need help, we can call on our global networks of support.
Let's use the magic spinner.
Let's see, I have it right here, or maybe Sue does.
I do.
Share in my our screen. Toolshed, here in the gardens of global unity, where all things are possible.
Okay, so I'm going to pull it up here. Ready? And brrr.
partnerships for the globe, for the goals. We're looking for people in Alachua County, Florida that are creating partnerships for the global goals.
Who will help us find people, places, and things that will help build partnership?
Hey, Victoria, I will. One of the most important partnerships in my life was my relationships with mentors who helped me and guide me on the right path.
I will. The United Church of Gainesville is hosting workshops for building Martin Luther King's World House.
I will. The Baha'is of Alachua County are building community in a changing climate with the Interfaith Climate Group.
I will. The Star Center Theater is helping to present Climate Collaboratory, the musical for Earth Day.
And I will. I'm organizing an event called the Arts and Climate Symposium.
And I will. The Climate Collaboratory offers these words of wisdom from the Earth Charter for the community-wide Climate Conversation to Action Program. It says, every individual, family, organization, and community has a vital role to play. The arts, sciences, religions, educational institutions, media, businesses, non-governmental organizations, and governments are all called to offer creative leadership. The partnership of government, civil society, and business is essential for effective governance.
Perfect. The roving reporters will want to know more from each one of you so we can learn from your example and inspire others.
Curious minds want to know that we kids want to see how you do what you do so we can learn from your experience.
We'll ask questions that you can answer in writing. Then we'll choose a few to interview so we can find out more.
We're learning to ask questions that will help us to find out what we need to know to make the world work for 100% of humanity and the community of life on Earth.
Hey kids, what about our global networks of support?
Let's ask how people in other parts of the world can help us build partnerships for the goals.
Who will help us?
Oh, Lolo's not here. Oops.
I have young people from Australia and South Africa who want to connect with the kids in Florida. I was so inspired by Dr. King's World House quote that I put it to music with the Emtherian movement for world peace.
Let me show you what that looks like.
This is a great new problem of mankind. We have inherited a big house, a great world house in which we have to live together, black men and white men, Easterners and Westerners, Gentiles and Jews, Catholics and Protestants, Muslims and Hindus, a family unduly separated in ideas, culture, and interests, who, because we can never again live without each other, must learn somehow in this one big world house with each other.
Okay. Stop the share.
Who will help us to build the partnerships for the goals?
Our friends at Pacha's Pajamas will. They want to animate our collaborative storytelling adventure with and play games with people all over the world. They know that we are all connected.
And I'll be right with you here. Let me get this next one up, sorry. Here we go.
Good morning, Pacha.
What about a global dance party that brings us all together? Imagine everyone across the world dancing and singing, "We are all connected."
Sounds like something the world really needs right now.
Yeah, let's do a video. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. We are all connected. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
There we go. So we are all connected.
And the girls at Kabingo Youth Care Activists in Uganda want to partner with youth groups in Alachua County for climate education through the arts.
We have many more people, places, and things from our global networks of support to help create partnerships for the goals.
We can find them in our tool shed. In the gardens of global unity, where all things are possible.
That's WE, the world's project incubator, where people of all ages are growing seed ideas from vision to reality.
And we have a song for that.
I spent a long time running. I never knew then what I know now. That the fruits, they always come in, but you can't go around just knocking them down. It takes a long time to show in. We plant the seeds then and we look at them now. But the roots are always growing, no matter if I'm there or never around.
Whatever grows will grow, whatever dies will die, whatever works will work, whatever flies will fly, whatever fails will fail, what's meant to soar will soar. I am planting seeds, nothing
it's like
more.
Your whole life. You've been training for this moment, and when the time comes, you just disown it, meaning you just surrender, don't control it. Not interested in the clay pots and mold it. Or sitting next to the path, trying to unfold it, or waiting for the fruits to fall down toward you. Let it go, and now you're flowing, feeling quite gorgeous. So you take steps away instead of towards it. What a rush, feeling freedom with nothing to hold. We've been taught that what you touch will always turn to gold. And now we're learning when we let it go, it overflows with no credit to take, because no credit is home. A higher power working.
So he goes on, and this is a wonderful song. I enjoy that one so much.
All right, and cut. Great rehearsal, everyone. What do you think?
Victoria, what do you think about that?
I think it was good.
How about other thoughts?
Well, I did think that everything we said is really good, and we should, and this is actually, just so you know, for everyone that's watching, don't really paint walls when it's not your property.
Good advice. Thank you. How about others? What do you think about this version? This is part four of our six parts in this building community. And can you see how we can use some of these ideas?
Well, I agree, Victoria. You definitely shouldn't paint walls that aren't your own property. But I think we got a lot out of tonight. I think it was a really good way to engage different communities across the globe, and to show that we are all so interconnected and everything can be involving everybody who wants to be part of it.
Anyone else? Helen.
Yeah, I just think this idea of the partnerships is so important, because as one person, I can only do so much. But whenever I talk to somebody else about what we're working on, that synergy and the excitement just reinforces my energy, and that this is the right time to be doing what we're doing. But the partnerships, we cannot do it alone. It is so important.
Yes, indeed. And so, Marie?
I think music is a powerful tool, and it serves to unite when other forms of medium doesn't. And so by having these collaborations, I think that the music will help spread the spirit of the collaboration, and it speaks volumes. Yeah.
And Aaron.
Yeah, just to add to what Dr. Duncan, what Sue Marie was just saying, as well as Helen and Victoria, we have so much more in common as human beings than I think that we're, it seems like the media these days is constantly trying to focus on differences. And music and the arts are some of the greatest ways for us to connect with one another. So yeah, just to emphasize that, I think that's such a beautiful thing that we're trying to do here.
Thank you. Let me just interject here that Victoria, we are figuring out ways that we can engage a lot more kids, because I know we have two more in your family that were not able to be here tonight, and we hope they'll be back. But we are inviting other kids to come in and help us tell this story, especially when we get going in March and April in our Climate Collaboratory, the musical. So I sure do thank you for being here tonight. And I know you have other plans, so we're going to let you go and the grown-ups can continue this conversation. Okay?
Great seeing you, Victoria.
So good to see you, Victoria.
Bye, Victoria.
Bye,
bye. Sweetie.
Have a nice day.
You as well.
So, and Tabby, you had a comment? Oh, you got to do yours, yes?
Yeah, that's all I had to say.
Okay, sorry. Anyone else?
Well, like Victoria, I have to leave here as well. But before I do, I also just want to mirror what everyone is saying. I think that, you know, that partnership piece, when we're looking at something like climate, you know, sometimes it feels like it's really easy just to think that it's ours to do, but when it's really just, it's ours to do, right? This is a world issue. And the more that we can work together, the greater our effect is going to be. You know, when we come together, we're going to be greater than the sum of our parts, right? And yeah. So that's a big part of the work that we do at RPCP. And we hold, you know, those partnerships that we have with organizations and with community members as so important, because it's the only way to affect change. And so with that, I thank you all as well.
Yeah, just explain, RPCP is?
The River Phoenix Center for Peace Building. Yeah, so not climate specifically, but climate relevant for sure.
So we've got some a conflict to resolve here with our planet.
Exactly.
And, we need peace.
Yes, exactly.
And we need peace.
And just to add on what, you know, Dr. Duncan and Helen and Aaron mentioned as well, you know, I'm a musician as well. And so I really love this idea, you know, wherever I travel in the world, music is one of those things that does bring people together, but it's also just this common language. You know, we don't even need to understand what we're saying, and we can really understand each other through music. And I think dance is that way, and theater is that way, the arts are that way. So it's a really powerful tool.
So we'll see you. And thank you so much for coming, Eric.
Yes, thank you all. Bye-bye.
Bye. Okay. So, Shannon, we're going to go to the next part here.
Okay. Well, I was just listening. Well, let's think of more human, material, and spiritual resources for our tool shed. What other people do you know that are creating partnerships for a world that works for all? And then we're going to have people type in their responses in the chat so we can collect them at the end of the show, right? So think about the spiritual, material, or other human resources that we need for our tools shed. I also just wanted to add that think outside of where your normal places might be, that you intersect with that, like Eric was saying, is all part of the same conversation. And so where should climate conversation be? Everywhere.
Yes.
So, okay.
So the question is, what other people do you know? Let's talk about people first that are creating partnerships. I have one. And so, please, everybody, so just put yours in.
Sue, are you talking specifically creating partnerships around climate?
No, just partnerships that we can work, because we're doing 17 sustainable development goals, and that has to do with every aspect of people, planet, everything that we do on this planet. So partnerships are at many, many different levels.
I'll type this in also, but with the University of Florida as the hub in this city in Gainesville, the IFAS program builds partnerships in so many ways to provide food and agriculture for the people. And hopefully we will be developing those resources that sustain the planet and minimize our fossil fuels in the process.
Yeah, we'd love to get the university involved in lots of wonderful ways. And Aaron, thank you for coming. Look, I see your F for Florida, right?
That was unintentional, but.
But you're at the university, and we're just really glad to have you here. Yeah. Tell a little about the Arts in Medicine program. You're working with them, are you not?
Yeah, you know, in fact, I'm really thankful to say that this morning, associated with this Arts and Climate Symposium work, I was able to present to the faculty and staff of the University of Florida Center for Arts and Medicine. I've been a research and graduate assistant with them for about 7 years. Regarding some funding that I'm looking for to host this symposium, this morning I presented a brief presentation to those individuals. Yeah.
Good luck with that. Yeah. I was around, I guess it was in the early 90s when that program was just getting off the ground, and I thought, why? Using music to help people heal, and the arts going in and just helping people to be creative, even though they are not feeling so good in many ways.
Yeah, absolutely. It does. As we've discussed earlier in this program, it really helps folks connect in whatever way they're trying to connect. As Sue Marie mentioned, it is powerful, the arts.
So what else do we see in our chat, Shannon?
We see high school or a collegiate model, UN groups, the IFAS to connect ag people that Helen was talking about to provide food for people across. So those are a couple. I was just thinking as Aaron was speaking, I was thinking about some partnerships here that are kind of happening, which are exciting to see. And in that health, music, culture, arts connections that all are so critical to the conversation about how we heal ourselves and the earth, because it's kind of that interconnectedness, right? And all of it, you know, all of the, even the profound kind of the combination of the ag information and the music information and the, what we know, you know, the profound effects that we know words and music can have on at a molecular level. And, you know, that's amazing, right? So if music heals us as human beings, it also heals the earth, right? There are, because we're kind of made up of the same elements, folks. So when you talk about healing the water, like Dr. Emoto, the studies that he did about, you know, how to heal the water, and if we're made up of water, and we know that we can shift and change at a molecular level the molecules within water, dependent upon the sounds, then what does that say about our ability to heal ourselves if we're made up of 70% and our brains 80% water? Wow, how powerful is that? So tapping into all of that and saying, how are we connected to the earth being healed and our own wellness? And not just at this, you know, kind of macro level that we often think about it, but what does that mean for us as individuals and what opportunities and power and control we have? The good news, Sue, as you said, that we're telling this story, of this story, that we have the ability to shift by our, you know, on our individual levels in ways that can have profound impacts. That's powerful, you know. So so I just want to say thank you to everybody that's here and that's doing the work, because as Helen said, we are made from stardust. Yes. Right, we are, absolutely.
We're all from the same source, whatever that is, right?
Yeah.
So we have I wanted to go back to the comment here about high school and collegiate model UN, because I think that's so important. I was inspired by model UN when I was in high school, and it just helped me to get this worldview that was different from anything that I'd experienced before. And I know that, Tabby, have you had experience with the model UN?
Right. So I was what you could call an honorary group leader for my Mommy UN in high school because I could not attend the meetings on a regular basis because I was in two other really action-oriented clubs that met at the same time. But they were nice enough to say, it's okay, like you can come along for the ride. And I am forever grateful to them because I learned so much just from, you know, everything that they do. And our advisor was just such a great mentor to all of us. And before I really got to know that group, I was just concerned with, you know, American politics, American news. And I never really had a news source outside of NBC or ABC. And after that club, I just had so much of a more globalized view of everything and just how everything is connected. And I was lucky enough to visit the UN headquarters in New York and go on a tour there, which was just an amazing, amazing experience. I will never forget that. And it just kind of, when you step into the General Assembly room, I don't know if anyone else has been in there, but it's just a feeling of immense just partnership, I guess, just the possibility of collaboration, and you can feel it when you walk in that room. So I've always tried to take that with me wherever I go.
Beautiful. Well, I'm so glad you brought it here. And I want to say that some of our partners on this project with the Building Community in a Changing Climate are from the United Nations Association of Gainesville. And something that I admire so much about that organization is every year when they celebrate UN Day, they bring in you know, wonderful speakers, but also the co-sponsors who all, you know, when it was in person, we all had tables all the way around. So we were part of the whole to be there. And just having all those partners ready, I feel like they're ready to help us do what needs to be done to get this climate conversation and really the wellness conversation. And I think that's the way we need to present this, especially if we can bring in people in the, for example, arts and medicine, or, you know, going into the schools, and it doesn't matter where we're going, some kind of wellness approach is gonna be very helpful. So, shall we go on? We got more to share if you guys are willing. Shannon, you want to take that? Oh, no, this is Tony. Tony was going to say, let's think of more places where we can develop partnerships for the goals. These might be schools or faith groups, organizations or businesses, cities or countries. Could be any place. What do you think of? Let's take a minute, put some ideas into the chat, and that will help us to have our conversation.
Yeah, we got the city of Gainesville and Alachua County, the public schools with music and arts, Quiddy Creek Nature Park. Yeah, partnering with the...
I'd like to say something about the city of... In fact, I'll let Helen Warren tell us about the important work that our city and county commission are doing.
Well, they have had a committee that's been working on issues of the climate emergency and working to identify steps that as a government, municipalities and the county can take action to reduce their fossil fuels and do things to support the goals that will make this place a better place for our children and our grandchildren.
And they did declare a climate emergency. And that actually was at the same time in 2019 that we were getting this Climate Collaboratory established as it's a pilot project of We the World and the University of Florida Extension. And so we're kind of laying the groundwork for the vision to come into reality. And it just is really wonderful to see the networks, the partnerships that are evolving around this project. How about some others?
Ellen also added the University of Florida and Santa Fe College are another partners that you could think about partnering with. And
we actually last week had Bill Dorman from the business incubator at Santa Fe College. And so helping with our project incubator that we're developing for the Gardens of Global Unity, where all things are possible.
And so. all the Chamber of Commerce is another one.
Yes.
We have to get the businesses involved in this.
Right. Yes.
Right. And what about all the libraries?
Yes.
Who goes to the Library Association and partners up with the libraries?
Cool.
Always thinking about, when I think about this, I always think about what am I doing in my daily life? Where are the places I'm going? What are the just in my life, right? And everybody else is living a similar life in terms of we all go to the grocery store. We all do this. We all do that. You know, all of that is happening. So where are the intersects if we want to invite people into partnership?
Mm.
You know, thinking about all of those places, faith groups, Aaron's saying, are great places, and particularly in the Southern United States. So that's worship events, ceremonies, celebrations, connecting with others, you know.
So I was just thinking about the Martin Luther King Commission here in Gainesville that has wonderful outreach through the community for people doing different activities based on the teachings or words of Dr. Martin Luther King. And Sylmarie, I know that the Star Center Theater is really involved in the Martin Luther King activities. Could you tell us a little about that?
Well, the Star Center Children's Theater is really active in performing music, drama, spoken word at all of these events. As a matter of fact, today they're taping for an upcoming event for the parents of the Caring and Sharing School. So they, through their music, they have a vast outreach, and you know it's because of the people who surround them and support them and teach them and take care of them. But it's helping them to develop a greater sense of community as they go around.
Beautiful. I know. I so admire the work of Star Center Theater. You just reach into the community in so many different ways. It's a beautiful thing. Mm-hmm. So let's think of more things that we can use to develop partnerships for the goals. So these could be the books or movies, games, activities, programs for schools and community groups. We can also use quotations from the sacred text, great thinkers or famous people past and present in our words of wisdom. So what are some thoughts? Take a minute to jot in the chat some of your ideas.
Since we're live on Facebook, I think it's good that we have some conversations too instead of silence. But there are so many wonderful videos out there and documentaries. And one that comes to mind that I think is really fantastic is a documentary called the smallest, oh God, now I'm going to forget the name of the biggest little farm, the smallest big farm. Oh, I'll have to look that up, but it's,
I think it's the biggest little.
The biggest little farm with a couple out in California that take a place that had been a monoculture of a farm and had just basically turned itself into a desert. And the couple solicited the help of a plant whisperer, just an incredible human being who could look at the pieces of that property and bring life back to it in a balanced way. That is just a wonderful resource for people to look at and talk about the importance of taking care of our agricultural systems. And then of course, a story of stuff. I've asked some of the college kids that I know in our neighborhood if they're familiar with that, and it's unknown to the current generation of students. So we, you know, some things just never grow old. And I watched the video recently of one of the segments of the story of stuff, and it is just as relevant now as it was 15 years ago.
Yes, indeed. So let me just add that we have the story of stuff is part of our outreach that we will be doing starting during March and April of this year, but especially when we get into the fall, and putting that out as a program that's perfectly appropriate in high schools. And I've been involved with the beginnings of an interfaith version of that to involve people of different faith groups, to especially the young people with the elders as their support, networks of support. And that's my seed idea that I want to grow next year, especially. So I think that's a great resource. Any others?
I would recommend a book called Braiding Sweetgrass by Robin Kilmer. And it really is indigenous knowledge and botany that is combined in a way that people understand this world relational view. So it's a great book to help introduce people to some ways of thinking that really have to do with reciprocity and taking care of the earth and ourselves. So
I would like to also add potentially a random example, but if y'all haven't seen or heard of The Octopus Teacher,
yes,
it's such an amazing film about connection and overcoming all kinds of doubts in oneself. And it's sort of a trauma therapy kind of an issue, because I believe the main character was overcoming a significant issue with, I believe, his daughter dying or something like that in a car accident. Anyways, it's all about him learning from an octopus that he befriends through a very long process of getting over the cold initially, of going into the ocean. And the way it's filmed is just beautiful. The music, he has an interview. It's just a stunning story. And it's one of the greatest examples, I think, of how a human being can connect with nature through perseverance and persistence.
Beautiful. And Helen?
To reply to Aaron, your comment that you put in the chat about faith groups, Sue and I have talked about a project that Bill Moyers did in 1990, where there was a gathering of individuals representing faith groups across the globe. The Dalai Lama was there, teachers in the university level of other faith groups, indigenous people from the United States primarily. But what they did is they gathered to talk about how their doctrine, their religious doctrine, guided them as human beings in taking care of the planet or not. And it was just a really fantastic discussion and very enlightening. And, you know, it'd be pretty cool to do something like that in our current state of the world, and to identify how do we deal with the climate change and a faith that gives us all hope.
Yeah. I would love to talk with you more about that. Absolutely.
Beautiful. Nice having you in our community, Erin.
Oh, thanks.
Well, I thank you all for participating in our workshop series, Building Community in a Changing Climate. Please join us again next Tuesday at 6 o'clock Eastern when the Interfaith Climate Group explores global goals for the planet with the Climate Collaboratory, a pilot project of We the World at we.net and the University of Florida Extension.
And we're going to close with these words of wisdom from the Earth Charter. Let ours be a time remembered for the awakening of a new reverence for life, the firm resolve to achieve sustainability, and the joyful celebration of life.
I left out one line of that, I'm so sorry. It says, the firm resolve to achieve sustainability, the quickening of the struggle for justice and peace, a very important part of this, and the joyful celebration of life. So we are on our path on the road to 2030, 2050 and beyond. And it's just great to have all of you with us. And I thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Peace on earth, everybody.
Thank you.
On earth, indeed. Thank you. Bye. And thank you, Angel.
Good night.
You're welcome.
Bye-bye.